Hello friend, this is Jimmy from Can Have an Immigration Canada. This video is specifically for the international students who are waiting for the universities to open for in-class person classes, like in-person classes. So with the promise from the Canadian government that most of the Canadians will be vaccinated by the end of September this year, the post-secondary institution are more confident they will be safer to return to in-person classes for the fall semester of the year 2021. The return to the in-person learning activities, mostly depending on the health authorities and their guidelines also, but most of the universities have made their plan. And I'll go mostly province by province who have, some of the universities have already given their green light for the fall semester, especially for international students to come to Canada and have a in-person classes. If we look at starting from the British Columbia, UBC, University of British Columbia, confirmed that they are planning to return to the in-person classes and increase in-person research in this fall. Also, if we look at the other universities in British Columbia, University of Victoria, Vancouver Island University, Thompson River University, Simon Fraser, University of Northern British Columbia, Capilano, and the Trinity Western University in British Columbia, they all have given the green light to be started in fall of 2021 for the in-person classes. If you look at Alberta, University of Alberta is also planning to welcome more students and staff back to their campus this fall. And also from the University of Calgary and University of Lethbridge, they are also planning a significant return to the campus this fall. Again, the situation, these factors are all come into play when the situation is going in the right direction also, right? But the numbers are, as per now, the numbers are going really down in Alberta, BC and other provinces. Also, the vaccination is at its full swing right now. So millions and millions of people have already been vaccinated here. So the whole country, they were planning to get it done by the end of September. So if that's the scenario and everything goes in the right direction, so we can see influx of large number of international students coming back to the in-person classes. If we look at Saskatchewan, University of Saskatchewan is also planning to bring back some level of in-person classes or instruction this fall. And Manitoba University of Brandon has not released any detail on returning to in-person instruction so far. The university's registrar said, "Our intention is to announce a course of action for fall 2021 that we'll commit to without needing to backtrack or pivot midway through the term." So they are still looking at the situation. So hopefully in a month or so, they will also come up with their plan. University of Manitoba is planning to allow classes with a maximum of 20 students in each class to return in-person instruction. Lab classes will be limited to no more than 25 classes. Larger classes will continue to operate remotely. Now let's go to one of the biggest province in Ontario. The University of Toronto is aiming to allow in-person instruction and support for students in this fall. Brock University is planning to offer as many courses as on campus as possible, including labs and other experiential learning, graduate seminars, undergraduate classes. University of Ottawa is expected to provide a full on-campus experience this year. Western University in Ontario is planning to return to face-to-face instruction and offer more campus activities. University of Windsor is also planning a major return to face-to-face and on-campus activity fall of 2021. If we look at Quebec has already previously announced that universities and colleges could gradually return in person instruction 1 day a week at this moment, but physical distancing measure must be respected both in and out the classes. McGill University in Quebec is expecting to return to in-person classes in September. Concordia is planning for an announcement about the fall in the month of May. They haven't made any plans so far, but looking in the right direction. If you look at New Brunswick, St. Thomas University planning for both online and in-person classes in 2021. Nova Scotia, Acadia University expecting a full return onto the campus this fall. Staff and students are asked to begin preparing for in-person learning. Dalhousie University in Nova Scotia expecting the class size restriction may keep larger lectures classes online. So, in the media release from Dalhousie University, the university says it hopes to offer in-person learning activities of less than 100 people, such as tutorials, labs, and small to medium-sized classes. If you look at Prince Edward University, they are also expected to return a more than normal teaching and learning environment this fall. Newfoundland and Labrador Memorial University is already resuming their in-person research work after revising its decision to fully return to the in-person work this past February. So they are already in the place. So most of the provinces, if the one I have named so far, they have the plans to return. So if you are looking to submit your visa application for study permit, this is the best time for the fall. If you have a proper paperwork from the university, they have acceptance letter and everything is in place, just submit your file, because there might be delays expected. So that was a little update for international graduate students who want to come to Canada for their further studies. So I'll keep you guys updated if there'll be anything comes up or any changes comes up regarding Canadian immigration. Till then, you guys all have a good day. Thank you.